Brain of Britain, the nationwide general knowledge contest, chaired by Russell Davis.
Hello, thank you, and a warm welcome to another contest in our 2019 Brain of Britain tournament. Four competitors sit beside me here on the stage with no inkling of what they're going to be asked in the next 30 minutes or so. But what they do know is that the one who gives me the most correct answers will be through to the semi-final stage and therefore in with a chance of taking the 66th BBC Brain of Britain title in the summer. Let's meet today's contenders.
Hello, I'm Alan Clark, a retired air traffic control engineer from Southampton.
Hello, I'm Steve Goddard, a lecturer in French from Oxford.
Hello, I'm Rob Hemming. I'm an author and public speaker from Evesham.
Hello, I'm David Sherman. I'm a hospital administrator from Chelmsford in Essex.
You've all done pretty well to be sitting here at all, because what you know and listeners may not is that you've already come through quite a competitive audition process to earn your place in the series. The best of luck to you all today. Let's get proceedings underway today with your first question, Alan Clark. In the film Bohemian Rhapsody, about the career of the rock band Queen, which actor plays Freddie Mercury?
Rami Malek.
Yes, born in California, of Egyptian parentage in 1981. The Monte Rosa, a German passenger liner launched in 1930, became extremely famous in Britain in 1948 and again in 2018, under which alternative name?
The Windrush.
Windrush will do. The Empire Windrush in full, yes. The ship that brought us Caribbean workers and Calypsonians and re-emerged in the news last year. Which word that derives from the Latin for a wing and a foot can be applied to any one of the group of 34 species of aquatic mammals, including seals and walruses, with streamlined bodies and limbs used as flippers?
Pedipod.
No. A nice invention. Steve Goddard?
Pinniped.
Pinniped is right, yes. You see how close he was. That is the right answer. Steve Goddard, your question. According to St. John's Gospel, St. Thomas the Apostle was also known as Didymus. What does Didymus literally mean?
Is it twin?
It does mean twin, yes. One of the most influential plays of the 20th century, Waiting for Godot by Samuel Beckett, has been described as a symbolic portrayal of the human condition. The play revolves around two men who endlessly await the arrival of the mysterious Godot. Can you name either of them?
Estragon.
Estragon and Vladimir, yes. Godot himself, of course, never turns up. Cytology is the branch of biology that deals specifically with the formation, structure, and function of what?
Cells?
Yes. In 2018, which English artist earned the title of the world's most expensive living female artist after her 1992 nude self-portrait entitled Propped was sold at auction for £9.5 million?
I don't think it is, but Tracy Emin?
No, not on this occasion. Rob Hemming?
Barbara Hepworth?
No. David Sherman?
Sarah Lucas?
Nope. Anna Clark? Not going to
no
happen.
No.
Jenny Savile? Ring a bell now? Yes. Rob Hemming, in the hit BBC drama series of 2018, Bodyguard, Keely Hawes' character, Julia Montague, held which cabinet post?
Home Secretary?
Yes. What sauce is used in the dish Eggs Benedict?
Mayonnaise.
No. David Sherman?
Hollandaise.
Hollandaise. Poached eggs placed on a slice of ham on toast or a muffin with a covering of hollandaise sauce. Yes. David Sherman, according to Ernest Hemingway, the western summit of which mountain is called by the Maasai Ngaje Ngai, meaning the house of God?
Kilimanjaro?
Yes, from the opening page of his story, The Snows of Kilimanjaro. Ut ameris amabilis esto, or if you want to be loved, be lovable, is a quotation from The Art of Love by which Roman poet?
Mm.
out of time. Rob Hemming?
Virgil?
No. Alan Clark?
Juvenile?
No. Steve Goddard?
Ovid.
Ovid is right, yes, in full Publius Ovidius Naso. End of the first round, and these are the scores. Rob Hemming has 1, David Sherman 2, Alan Clark also 2, Steve Goddard 6. Right, we recommence with Alan Clark. What would a person with the condition known as logorrhea produce an excessive flow of?
Saliva?
No. Steve Goddard?
Words.
Words, speech, yes, from the Greek for word and flow. We're more familiar with the phrase verbal diarrhea, but the single word for it does both jobs, if you pardon the expression. Now, Steve Goddard, this is your question. Which British character actor's best-known roles include the bumbling Lord Percy in the second series of Blackadder and the devious Captain Darling in Blackadder Goes Forth?
Tim McInerney.
Yes, or McInerney, whichever you prefer, or whichever he prefers. In the last stanza of one of Dylan Thomas's best-known poems, with the penultimate line, "Do not go gentle into that good night," what 8 words follow that line to form the final sentence?
Rage, rage against the dying of the light.
Precisely so. Rhombic and monoclinic are the 2 main allotropes of which non-metallic element?
Carbon?
Not carbon, no. Rob Herring?
Calcium?
No. Alan Clark?
Silicon?
No, Dave German. Pick an element. No, sulfur is the right answer. Rob Hemming's question now. Who directed the 1997 film Titanic?
James Cameron.
Yes, right. According to the title of a best-selling novel published in 2015, who is Rachel Watson? Shake of head. No. David Sherman?
The Girl on the Train.
In the novel by Paula Hawkins, yes. David Sherman, it is your question too. In Russian folklore, there are various tales of a terrible ogress who cooks and eats her victims, usually children, and who rides through the air in a kettle or a mortar using a pestle for an oar. What is her name?
Baba Yaga.
Yes. Which Shakespearean character's final spoken line is, "I'll be revenged on the whole pack of you"?
Tybalt.
No, Steve Goddard.
Malvolio.
In Twelfth Night, Act 5, Scene 1, living up to his ill-willed name to the last. End of that round. Rob Hemming, Alan Clark, 2 apiece. David Sherman, 4. Steve Goddard, now 10. Alan Clark, back to you again. And music accompanies your next question. It's a song that was in the charts all of 40 years ago this month by Supertramp, the band who took their name from the title of an autobiography by the Welsh poet W.H. Davis. No relation, as far as I know. I'd like you to tell me the title of their million-selling album of 1979, which included this song. I said, now what would you say? Album was?
Logical.
No. David Sherman.
Breakfast in America.
Yes, that was the album title. That was the logical song. I always liked Breakfast in America itself best anyway. Steve Goddard, first published in 2016, The Pigeon Tunnel, Stories from My Life, is a book of memoirs by which best-selling British author known especially for spy thrillers?
John le Carré?
Yes, the pseudonym of David John Moore Cornwell. A custom loathsome to the eye, hateful to the nose, harmful to the brain, dangerous to the lungs. This description of smoking is taken from a polemic entitled A Counterblast to Tobacco, written by a British monarch. Which one?
Is it James the First?
It is James the First, or James the Sixth of Scotland, and it was published in 1604 and extremely prescient for its time. Which common six-letter adjective is applied scientifically to an acid, a base, or an electrolyte if they are completely ionized in aqueous solution?
Solute?
No. David Sherman?
Saturated.
No. No more offers? No. It is a very common six-letter adjective. It's strong. Ooh. That's all it is. Rob Hemming, which three words finish this quotation from St. Augustine of Hippo's Confessions, which he wrote about his prayers as a youth? Give me chastity and continence.
God help me.
No, Steve Goddard?
But not yet.
But not yet is right. Yes, yes. David Sherman, what term, derived from an Italian word meaning paper, was originally used for an artist's preparatory drawing, but is now more familiar with a different connotation in popular culture?
Paparazzi?
No. Steve Goddard?
Is it cartoon?
It is cartoon, yes. So you mustn't blame Leonardo because his cartoon isn't very funny. That is the end of a round. Rob Hemming has 2, Alan Clarke still 2, David Sherman 5, Steve Goddard 14. Mm. Okay. And at roughly the halfway point in today's contest, let's take a breather. Our contenders can sit back, crack their knuckles, and work as a quiz team for a few minutes. Because I have a couple of ingenious questions here from a Brain of Britain listener who's hoping to win a prize by beating the brains. Today, it's Carolyn Wolstenholme from Carnforth in Lancashire who has the chance to tease our competitors. She sent in 2 related questions, which she hopes you'll enjoy, and if you can't answer them correctly, she'll be receiving a book voucher prize. So, here goes. Question 1, and very simple. Who lived at number 52 Festive Road?
It's not something like Mr. Ben, is it? From the, Mr. Ben, is it? From
could the, be. I was thinking that. I'm not sure it is, but...
I'm not
sure if I hadn't thought of it.
Does anything go for it?
It's not Mr. Ben, is it?
It is, you know. Very well done. The children's character created by David McKee, character noted for his regular visits to a fancy dress shop where the dressing room led to a universe of strange adventures. Well, in a way, that was just a prelude to Carolyn's second question, which is this. What's the connection between Mr. Ben, Cathy Come Home, and the radio detective D.S. Dave Brooke?
Brooks. Yeah.
He was Brooke.
Okay.
I guess he was in.
Very happy to go with that.
Yeah. Hey,
Brooks.
Yeah, go on.
It's Ray Brooks.
The actor Ray Brooks?
The actor Ray Brooks.
Correct. Well done. He provided.
It's a bit mean, isn't it? Because somebody put that in.
Yes. Can you elaborate on that?
He was. He played the detective in D.S. Brooke.
Yes.
He narrated Mr. Ben.
He did.
He was the bone voice. And he was in Cathy Come Home.
He had a starring role in Ken Loach's Cathy Come Home in 1966. He was also prominent in the 60s movie The Knack and How to Get It, and in the BBC TV comedy drama Big Deal, which many people will remember. So, thank you, Carolyn. The brains actually did rather well with your questions this time, so we can't send you a prize. But you can earn from all of us here at the Radio Theatre this riotously festive round of applause. If you'd like to send us question ideas to try out on the brains, it's very easy to get them to us. You can email them to brainofbritain@bbc.co.uk or send them via the Contact Us link on our web pages. If you prefer to write them down and put them in the post, you can address them to Brain of Britain, BBC Dock House, Media City, Salford, M50, 2LH. We can't reply to all the suggestions we receive, I'm afraid, but we will make every effort to let you know in plenty of time if we plan to include them in a programme. Let's get back to the contest then. With everything still to play for, it's Alan Clark's turn once more. In the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus recounted to his disciples eight individual blessings known as the Beatitudes. The first Beatitude begins, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is..." what?
"The kingdom of heaven."
Yes. Patrick Pemberton, Ian Smith, Rodney Wallace and Joel Campbell were all named in the same squad for the 2018 World Cup. For which country do they play?
Ireland.
No. Steve Goddard?
Australia?
No. Rob Hemming?
South Africa?
No. Have a go, David Sherman, yes.
Jamaica?
No. Of all things, it's Costa Rica.
Oh, wow.
I know, it seems most unlikely, but there it is. Steve Goddard, there's music with your next question. This was the second single released by the British group Suede. When we've heard the extract, I'd like you to tell me its title, which was taken from that of a children's TV series starring a robot.
Only one I can think of is Metal Mickey.
It's the right answer. Well done. TV series popular in the 1980s, directed by the former member of the Monkees, Mickey Dolenz. In biology, what name is given to the jelly-like substance that surrounds the nucleus of a living cell and is enclosed by the cell membrane?
Is it the cytoplast?
I think it's near enough, yes. It's cytoplasm. Would have been better with an M, but I can hardly deny you the point for that. Star Trek's James Tiberius Kirk will be born in the year 2233. In which Midwest American state?
Iowa.
Oh, very good. Yes, Iowa. The city of Riverside, Iowa, is already a tourist center because of the association with Star Trek. Which military figure was once described by David Lloyd George as brilliant to the top of his army boots?
Kitchener?
No. David Sherman?
Duke of Wellington?
No. Rob Hemming?
Churchill?
Nope. Alan Clark?
Haig?
Yes, Douglas Haig, the first Earl Haig. It was a remark that seemed to start out as a compliment and then stopped. Rob Hemming, which pretender to the throne was pardoned by Henry VII after the Battle of Stoke in 1487?
Lambert Simnel.
You've got him. Lambert Simnel is right. Which American slang word for a marijuana cigarette also has an important but very different meaning in the works of J.K. Rowling?
Spliff?
No. Can't remember any spliffs in Harry Potter. Well, you never know. Steve Goddard.
Could be Hufflepuff, couldn't it?
It ought to be, but it wasn't. Alan Clark?
Muggle.
Muggle, yes. In the Harry Potter books, it's someone not born of parents with witching powers. Louis Armstrong recorded a track called Muggles in 1928. Fortunately for him, there were no lyrics. Now, David Sherman, what's the title of the poem by Andrew Marvell that includes the famous lines, "But at my back I always hear time's winged chariot hurrying near"?
Is that to his coy mistress?
It is, and it continues, "And yonder all before us lie deserts of vast eternity." Yes. What is the transparent outer layer of the front of the eyeball called?
Cornea.
It is. Death and taxes and childbirth. There's never any convenient time for any of them. Which fictional American character, the heroine of a novel first published in 1936, spoke these undeniably true words?
No, I've no idea.
Right. Rob Hemming.
Jay Gatsby.
No. Steve Goddard.
Scarlett O'Hara.
Yes, in Gone with the Wind by Margaret Mitchell. Well done indeed. End of a round, and the scores have advanced in this way. Rob Hemming, 3. Alan Clark, 5. David Sherman, 7. Steve Goddard, 18. Right, Alan Clark, your question. Which two of the five components in the modern pentathlon have been combined into a final event?
Steeplechase and javelin?
No. That would be quite painful to manage, wouldn't it? Yeah. Rob Hemming.
Running and shooting.
Yes, pistol shooting and running, yes. The combined event is known as the laser run. Steve Goddard's question, which singer has used the mathematical symbols for addition, multiplication and division as titles for his albums?
Ed Sheeran.
Yes, yes. Correct. When you're on a run, you're on a run. Yes. Which NFL team won the 2019 Super Bowl?
Washington Redskins.
No. Rob Hemming?
New England Patriots.
Yes, they beat the Los Angeles Rams to win their 6th Super Bowl title. Rob Hemming, have a listen to an audio clip now from a classic 1960s children's television series and tell me which series began each of its episodes with this, accompanied by a shot of a rotating musical box.
Here is a box, a musical box, wound up and ready to play. But this box can hide a secret inside. Can you guess what is in it today?
Play school.
No. David Sherman.
Jack and Ori.
No. Alan Clark.
Play away.
No. Steve Goddard.
Parsley the Lion.
No. Camberwick Green. We heard the voice of the incomparable Brian Cant. Camberwick Green was the first children's animated television show to be aired in colour on the BBC. First transmitted in 1966 and then regularly repeated for many years thereafter. David Sherman, which is the only winner of the Academy Award for Best Picture to feature an exclamation mark in its title?
Crash?
No. Steve Goddard?
Is it Oklahoma?
It isn't, no. Alan Clark?
Apocalypse Now?
No. These all deserve an exclamation mark, but they didn't get one. Any more offers? No. Well, of all things, it's Oliver. Oliver the Musical. That surprises me, I must say. End of a round again. Rob Hemming and Alan Clark, 5 each. David Sherman, 7. Steve Goddard, 19. And I'm sorry to say, gentlemen, that this has got to be the final round. Alan Clark, in which calendar year was Bill Clinton sworn in as President of the United States? The Maastricht Treaty came into force, establishing the EU, and Czechoslovakia split in two to become the Czech Republic and Slovakia.
1992.
I'm sorry to say it wasn't. No, Rob Hemming.
93
is right, yes. Steve Goddard, whilst most composers of themes for TV entertainment shows don't exactly become household names, the former BBC music director who wrote the music for such successes as Are You Being Served?, Some Mothers Do Have 'Em, Last of the Summer Wine, and The Two Ronnies, was a legend in his lifetime. Who was he?
Ronnie Hazlehurst.
Yes. He was also the music director for the Eurovision Song Contest on the occasions when Britain hosted it and conducted the British entry in 7 separate contests. He died in 2007. In Greek mythology, which fabled race who resided in a distant land beyond the north wind lived for 1,000 years, but if that proved too long, could choose to adorn themselves with garlands and throw themselves off a rock into the sea?
Was it the Lotus Eaters?
It wasn't, no. Alan Clark?
The Amazons.
No. Yes, Rob Hemming.
The Furies.
No. Sound furious enough, but no. Hyperboreans. Hyperboreans is the right answer for that. Now, Rob Hemming, I'm going to describe a painting of 1946 by a well-known artist. The painting depicts a deer whose arrow-pierced body is conjoined to the artist's own head, from which antlers are growing. It's one of numerous self-portraits created by whom?
Picasso.
No, Steve Goddard.
Sounds a bit like Lucian Freud.
A little bit, but not that much. No more offers? No. Frida Kahlo is the answer, yes. David Sherman, there's music with your next question, and it's an instrumental piece called A Beautiful Mine. Have a listen and tell me which award-winning American TV series it was the theme to.
That NYPD Blue?
No. Alan Clark?
Mad Men?
Mad Men, yes. It's by musician, DJ and producer RJD2. And gentlemen, that was the final round, and these are the final scores. Rob Hemming has 6. Alan Clark has 6. David Sherman, 7. Steve Goddard, 20. So very well done, Steve Goddard. That was a resounding win. We'll be seeing you again when the semi-finals roll around. It's been a pleasure to have the four of you here today. We'll be in the north of England again next week, meeting another 4 potential brains of Britain. From us all, until then, goodbye.